Now we come to larynx. Larynx is chiefly made up of cartilages. The only bone in relation to the larynx is the hyoid bone. The cartilages are epiglottis cartilage, which is just behind the tongue, the thyroid cartilage, which is anteriorly, absent posteriorly, and the cricoid cartilage, which is wider posteriorly compared to the anterior aspect. Above the cricoid cartilage lies an important cartilage, which is the arytenoid cartilage. Then there are the folds. The upper fold is the ventricular fold, and the lower fold is the vocal fold. Between the epiglottis and the arytenoid cartilage, there is another fold which is known as the aryepiglottic fold. Now there are number of muscles which are controlling the larynx. These muscles are depicted in the model. Now we come to muscles of the larynx. The one muscle of the larynx which is placed outside is the cricothyroid muscle. This cricothyroid muscle is the tensor of the vocal cord. This muscle is the thyroarytenoid. From the back of thyroid cartilage to the arytenoid cartilage, and is the relaxer of the vocal cord. From the arytenoid cartilage to the epiglottis is the aryepiglottic muscle. This closes the inlet of the larynx. Here this muscle is the thyroepiglottic muscle. Thyroepiglottic muscle, from the back of the thyroid cartilage to the epiglottis, and this is opens the inlet of the larynx. The most important muscle of the larynx is the posterior cricoarytenoid muscle, arising from the back of the cricoid cartilage to the muscular process of the arytenoid cartilage. This is the muscle which causes abduction of the vocal cords and is a life-saving muscle. The other muscle is the lateral cricoarytenoid. From the arch of the cricoid cartilage to the muscular process of the arytenoid cartilage, and it causes adduction of the vocal cord. So the life-saving muscle is a pair of posterior cricoarytenoid muscles.